Hey guys, you know the best thing about pre-recording on the phones? They've got the thing that makes your skin look beautiful and smooth and nice, whereas if you look at the video that I did before, it's horrific. So this is going to be your stretch, and what I haven't put is actually stretch and roll. So today you are going to need a mat. Foam roller and one of these bad boys. So what I'm going to focus on in this stretch session is, that would have been funny if I dropped that, upper body. So I did lower body last week and a big focus on knees. So this week I'm going to focus on releasing quite a lot of the tension up in the shoulders, the lats, the back, and biceps, triceps, forearms as well. I did a strength and conditioning Tuesday morning, yesterday morning, as it would be, and worked all this, so hopefully there's some DOMS there and we can stretch it all out. Alright, so stretching first, rolling second, shoes on or off, it's up to you. Just make sure that you are warm-ish, guys, before you kick off with any stretching sort of stuff. Again, I've just talked the Tuesday morning strength, so I'm warm. But you guys warm. I've got some different mindful meditation music today that sometimes is loud and sometimes isn't. So we'll see how it rolls. I have pressed play, although I doubt that you can hear it yet. All right, backing up. We've got to start with. Right, let's just take a second. As it's upper body, I want you to focus on relaxing a little bit first before we kick off. So, close your eyes, just listen. Just relax your shoulders. Away from your ears. You can move your neck from side to side, up and down. Forget about anything. Just relax. Remember, with the stretch sessions, I don't know about head, but in mind, I want you to focus on time to give back to you. It's not very often that you sit down and go, right, this is me. Forget about any issues that you've got going on. We're going to do this at the end as well, so after we've done our rolling, you can join in with it. You don't have to, it's up to you, but it's just a little bit of mindfulness. It's part of your day. Give me 10 more seconds and then we'll kick off properly. Back, take it into down face, and I want you to do the same sort of thing. So push back down towards the heels
And again, push through and down towards the floor from your hands. Slightly under the knee is fine. Position on all fours, bring your shoulder or your one hand through and just relax on the floor. Again, try not to push your butt back and put the other arm in front. Put my hand on the dusty floor. I told you, sometimes it's really quiet and sometimes it's really loud. Alright, bring this hand back in. Use it to lift yourself up. Change sides. Top hand comes in to lift you up and back to the fours. Alright. Same move, just turn your hands to face the opposite way. Feel that stretch in the forearm. If you want to increase the stretch at any point, move back slightly. Aware that we stretch out forearms, but when you think about how much you're holding bars and plates and things like that, forearms take about the room too. I'm going to try and keep this a lot less than an hour and keep it as close to the 30 minutes as possible today. Hopefully. Alright, turn the hands in. That means 15 minutes stretch, 15 minutes roll, right? Okie dokie. Let's do that back release a little bit. Back mobility. Happy cat, sad cat, or moo cow, or whatever it's called. We don't do names. Stretch. Tailbone out, head up, drop the back down. Nice deep breaths as you do this. One more, guys. Come back to me again. Okay. Stick with some standard stretches first off. So, open the hands wide, you're going to hit the chest. Push your thumbs down towards the floor to begin with. Now, as you open up the chest, just move your hands up and down. And you're going to start to feel it in your biceps as well. Says it's explicit too. I'm not sure there's any words to make it explicit.
hands together, pull behind and pull down. Chest and shoulders from the front, or from the back, as it were. Come up onto your knees. Now you lose my head. Imagine that I've come up onto my knees. Cross the arms, you don't have to interlace the fingers. Push the shoulders forward. Oh, do it from here. Punch your back forward. Really round off into that stretch into the upper back. Triceps. So you've got your two options again on these. So you can either have it as a standard tricep stretch here, or you can do the one where you interlace your fingers. Just about. From there. Okay. As long as you're keeping upright. Don't let this elbow push you forward. One of my sides is tighter than the other. I'm thinking it's the other hand, as I've decided to go with this one first. You should feel a nice little stretch in your shoulder as well, the other arm. Relax, gently come out of that one. I like these sessions, proofing music. Guesswork with the music. Go on. Yes! Did it! Look, is how long I am on time. Yes, 12 minutes, I'm on it. Doing well. Okay, neck. I've done it quite often with you guys, but it's a really important one, and not one that we do enough, I don't think. So I'm going to let you come down to your cross leg for this one. Take your ear to your shoulder. Just relax it there. Take a second. See whether it stretches on its own, eh? Should be able to feel it all down here. If you want to increase it, bend into your ear and pull your ear away from your shoulder. Walk your hands out to extend the stretch a little further. Keep your chin up to start, or drop it down next. Alright, same move, just drop the chin. Feel the stretch move into the back of your neck instead. Use your hand to return to the center. Change sides. Find it easier to close my eyes, by the way, rather than just step good way down into the camera. And it means that I get to relax a little bit too. Thank you.
fingertips out. My tummy just rumbled, I'm hoping it didn't make it to the video. Drop the chin. Back up. Alright, let's do the foam roll part first and then we'll move on to the ball part. For the ball part, especially for your arm stuff, you're going to need a surface to do it on. So if you just want to watch it and then do it on the kitchen surface or whatever afterwards, having not got the kitchen surface, I've got a bench top instead that will allow me to show you that instead. Okay, so we'll do the back to start. All your mats slipped off. Okay, so you know yourself, the back is very, very sensitive. You need to be careful with it. Arms folded here. If you feel at any point there's too much pressure going through your spine, stop. I'm not going all the way down my back here, sticking in the first part of it. Alright? There is something called a peanut roller that basically it will roll down either sides of your spine for the lower part, so that you're not putting pressure on your spine towards the lower part of your back, alright? So we're working the top half. Don't go low. Alright. So from here, lats and a little bit of shoulders if you roll up a little bit further. We'll come here first. So you're going to extend your arm out. If you think about where your lats are, yeah? That's not very nice at all. Oh, there was a big knot there. I actually can't roll anywhere on this because it hurts too much. But by all means, you guys go ahead. I'm just going to release pressure when it goes away a little bit and move the roller from there. Makes me want to swear, but I won't. Again, for me, upper body is something, especially my lats. I couldn't even tell you the last time my friend rolled my lats out. Not Scooby Dooby. It's slightly awkward position as well because I can't actually put the full weight on that. Just leaning forward slightly to hit a little bit more of the chest. Not rolling onto my boobs, guys. Ladies, don't do that. Yeah. Alright, I'm going to move it up slightly. Oh, that's not so bad. So again, all I'm doing is just moving slightly to feel where it either stretches it or allows that pressure to release on the fascia, which is the whole point of the foam roller. Or the muscle, not just the fascia. Put that in there as well for any fitness related people that can get. So by coming back slightly, I'm hitting more into my shoulders and back into the lats and into my armpit is also getting a nice stretch in there too. Just moving up a bit.
as a means. All right, change sides. Trying to keep it so that I'm still on time. Let's move that back. Okay, guys, you've only got to be gentle. If you feel that you're putting too much pressure on and it's not comfortable, get off of it. Isn't very comfortable, don't just find a happy point because that's pointless. Alright, again, just move it up just to get a little bit more into the armpit, into the back of the shoulders. Get a little bit of chest. Again, not onto the boobs. Ladies and gents. That's not very nice at all. Wiggle, wiggle. Last couple of seconds. Can't see what I'm supposed to be doing next. Alright, come out of that. That's all good, just. Okay. Alright, grab the ball. If you've got a ball. So, this is actually a proper sports ball. Shush, loud music. This is actually a sports ball, but you can use tennis ball if you want it. It's quite hard. So if you're not used to doing it, perhaps get a tennis ball instead. Alright? Or a softer massage ball if you've got. Normally they come in like a selection of three or something like that. So maybe get the three and use the softer one first. So, as I've just did a little bit on my chest, I'm just going to stay with that. So, you only lean onto it. It's difficult to show you from here because you can't really see where I'm putting it. But again, if you think about where you're working your chest muscles in a session, where you can feel it working, just roll on it from there. Even if we just stay on it a little bit, move it around. Ah, that's a good one. Yeah. Just looks like another lie down, doesn't it? I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it because you can't see. But it's also really good for the front of the shoulders. Yeah. Can you see that? I'm putting it just here. She says. See that there? It's the right wall, so I'm going to charge that because I can lift my back off if I wanted to. I'm just going to give you the shoulder while I'm here. Does this look weird? I feel like it looked weird. It's working for me though. It's the main idea, right?
Sorted. Right, come on. Hurry up and move on to your next. It's just so I get everything. I've written it all down. That's how I put chest. Forearm, tricep, bicep. And then we'll do the standing ones. So, like I said, we are mobile, by the way, so if you want to take the phone or the laptop, go for it. Here's a bench I prepared earlier. You are in complete control here. Forearm, right there. And guess what? You can do the other side exactly the same way. So if you want to do it on a bench, if you want to do it on the coffee table, doesn't really matter. So can you guess how tricep works? So it means as well that you're in complete control of the pressure that you apply as well. By the way, it's going to work better with the arm bent because it means that the muscle is tight. Biceps an interesting one. Small muscles, they don't need a lot of time. Or the big fatty blokes go, my biceps aren't small, they're huge. No, I don't know that we've got big burly blokes, have we? They're normally gym goers than class goers. Triceps in the last day or so, you should be able to feel that quite a lot. Again, just play around with it a little bit. There's no one set position for it. Keep going with that. Did you hear that crack then? That was my knee. Bicep. Forearms, triceps, biceps, shoulders a little bit more. You can do it on the mat, but you can do it on the mat, or you can do it on the floor, on a wall. I'm going to show you the wall option just because you can take away a little bit of pressure on the wall. It's quite hard when we're on the mat. So I need to move that camera, don't I? Otherwise you've just got to be with my...
Okay. If you ever get a sports massage around the shoulders, all around the shoulder blades and the traps, it's absolutely amazing. I miss my sports massages. Don't have them enough anymore. So I'm just working around the shoulder blade. Pull down a little bit. The reason that I put my shoulder blade behind my back like this, by the way, is so that it pushes the shoulder blade back basically, so you can feel where it is and guide all around it rather than going across the bone. Yeah? Alright. Understand it. Please don't get me. Yeah, just going around my shoulder blade to start with as I'm already down here with the ball. Yeah. And then I'll move it up. Up to my traps at the top. It's kind of just in. It's really hard to show you in. Without pictures, I'm pointing. So, right in at the top. There are a load of other muscles in there as well. I say a load, that's a lot. A few, also a few that you can hit at the same time. Even slightly into neck. Just make sure you're not going onto your spine, guys. This looks really odd for somebody that's just like stepping in at this point of the video and just seeing me rolling around with my back against the wall. I look like Baloo from the Jungle Book. Hey, if it works, right? Dropped it. Yeah. Final one then. This is why I'm not walking around on the floor without flip-flops or even on my feet. Right, I'm going to bring you back down to the floor. Oh, we're at 34, we're doing really well. Really well. Oh, so, shoulders, chest, back, lats, triceps, biceps, forearms. Oh, you should see the state of my back. It's dusty. Last one, neck. So again, I did this with you last week, but for tension and stuff like that is awesome. Right, again, so you've got to be very, very careful, guys. Don't just slam your neck down onto it or anything like that. Again, I like to just get a little bit of a stretch first off. So dropping my chin, finding that sweet spot on the wall first, and then dropping my chin so I can feel that stretching up my back or up my neck. Not my back, my neck. So think about the best double chin that you can give yourself. Drop your chin down to your chest. All right. Lift up, put it right into your neck. Right up next to your shoulders. Relax down onto it.